This is a section on factoring polynomials, and hopefully this will be review, because I won't go over it in class, because you're supposed to know already how to factor. But I thought I would put this together and help if necessary. I can answer questions about factoring, but I can't go over the whole entire thing. So here we go. First thing, common factors and factoring by grouping. First thing you need to do is understand terminology, know what I'm talking about. This greatest common factor, I've got two kinds. First one we're going to look at is common monomial factor. Common means it's common to all terms. Monomial means a single term. Could be a number, could be number and letter, could be just a letter. So in this first problem, I've got a binomial. If there is a lead-off negative, like I have with this negative 7, we always pull it out. So I'm going to pull out a negative 7, since 7 will go into both of these numbers. Variable-wise, I don't have anything in common. So I'm going to factor out a negative 7, and in parentheses, it should leave me x minus 3y. Remember, when you factor, it's the exact opposite of dividing. You're going to divide everything by that number you're pulling out. So another way to check yourself is to remultiply, redistribute, and you should come back up with the original problem. Next one, I have got 1, 2, 3, 4 terms. First thing I'm going to look at is see if there's a number that they all have in common. And it looks like I would have a 3. Variable-wise, they do not all have a D, so the only thing I can actually factor out common monomial-wise is a 3. So I'm going to factor out a 3. In parentheses, I'm going to factor out a 3 from all of these. I should have 3D to the 5th minus 4D cubed plus 7D plus 8. And again, recheck by distributing through. The last one, it's 1, 2, 3 terms. I've got myself a trinomial. Number-wise, they all have a 7 in common. X, the most I can pull out is the least I've got in any one term. I've got an x cubed, x squared, x. I only can factor out an x because it has to be common to all. So far I'm pulling out a 7x. Y, I can pull out a y cubed. So 7x, y cubed. There's my 7x, y cubed. In parentheses, I should have an x squared, y squared, minus 3xy, plus, looks like 9. So it's pulling out a common monomial. Common binomials, if you'll notice, what's different from these two from the prior problems is I've got a parentheses, and in the parentheses I've got something in common. It's a common binomial. So I think about pulling out the common parentheses, that y plus 7, so I'm going to actually pull those out, and what I have left over will go in the second parentheses, and that would be that my 3y minus 5. So there's the y plus 7, it gets pulled out, and what's put in at the back end are the leftovers once I pretty much pull these away. See if you see the next one. My a plus 3b and a plus 3b, they're common binomials. I'm going to factor it out, and what I have left over should be a 3a plus b. So I pulled out this in front, and in my parentheses in the back are my leftovers. So that's factoring out a common binomial. So I need you to know what I mean by common monomial and common binomial. Factor by grouping sort of has a combination of A and B. I've got a problem that's worked out here. Factoring by grouping usually is with respect to four terms, and you look at the first two terms and the last two terms. Something very specific here that you've got to be able to do. First two terms, you're going to pull out a common monomial. So out of these first two, I see a C, and I write my leftovers. Whatever sign leads the second group is the sign that comes here. So I'm going to pull out a positive. In this case, it looks like I've got a 7D in common. And in parentheses, once I factor out 7D, hopefully you'll see the 2A squared plus 3B squared. A lot of times when you factor by grouping, your parentheses that contain the binomials are the same. So now I'm going to do a common binomial factor. I'm pulling out the 3A squared plus 3B squared, and in the second parentheses, my leftovers, I have C plus 7D. Okay, so let's try this one. I've got four terms. I'm going to look at the first group, then look at the second group. First group, I see a Z in common. So I pull out a Z, leaving me 2Z plus 7. The sign, remember, whatever starts the second group comes down. So I'm going to be pulling out a negative. Since they technically don't have anything in common, they always have a 1. But when you factor out a negative 1, remember that changes all signs. Very important here because now my parentheses match. So I'm going to pull out, factor out that 2z plus 7, and in the second parentheses, my leftovers would be z minus 1. So that would be my factored form. Factoring by grouping. Now you need to pause me and you need to try these, and I'll go ahead and I'll keep talking, but you can pause me. So I've got four terms. The first group, it looks like I've got a 7y in common. Second group, I'm going to have a negative, looks like 9. If I pull out a 7y, it looks like I'm going to have a 4x plus 3y. I left off my y there. Oh no, Pooh Bear. I pulled out the y. So I've got 4x plus 3. Remember, I'm taking out a negative 9, leaves me 4x plus 3, parentheses match, you factor those out, and in the second parentheses, you should have 7y minus 9. Okay, this one. A couple of ways you could do this. I do see a lead-off negative here. There's been times that I'll pull out a negative and I'll hold on to it, and then I'll bring it back. But let's just hold on to it for right now and see what happens. So out of the first two, I see in common a negative a. The second two, I see a negative 7. So let's see what happens. So if I pull out a negative a, remember signs change, there's my a plus b. Pull out a negative 7, signs change, there's my a plus b. The big thing here is that my parentheses have to match, and they do. So I'm going to factor out my a plus b, and it will leave in my second parentheses a negative a minus 7. But I have seen, you know, here's a negative right here. If I factor out a negative 1 just from this parentheses, then it changes to this. I use the factoring out a common monomial, common binomial, and factoring by grouping for what's called the AC method to factor trinomials. So you need to get this terminology under your belt, because the next thing I'm going to do is factor out trinomials. So until later, bye-bye.